Yeah, hi everybody, and welcome back to a new lecture. And today we'll go and see how to create a virtual device, an Android virtual device, and we'll be running our first application. So let's go and start. So I will go to tools over here, and I'll go to AVD manager, or else you can also go from here, which is a toolbar, and you can see the icon over here, which is a AVD manager. Just click on this one. It will show you the Android virtual device manager, which is your virtual device manager. And I have already created a few of the device over here, but I'm going to teach you how to create a new virtual device. So down below over here is your option, which is a create a virtual device. Just click on this one, and from here you can select a TV, phone, Wear OS, or a tablet. We'll be working with a phone. Just select the phone from here category. And from here you can select any device that you prefer. So we should at least select one. I think I have already created some of the device. Let me check what other device that I have created. I have created a Pixel 2, Pixel 3, and Nexus 9. So Pixel, I don't have a Pixel XL, which is 5.5. You can see the device name and also size and the resolution and the DPI. So depending on the size requirement, whether you are targeting for which size. So depending on your size, you can select your device. So let me select this one. I think 3A. I think this one has a Google Play Store. So you can see that if there is an icon for this one, this means that there is a Play Store, and you can just log in and download and install an app from Play Store, and you can connect with a Play Store service. But if the icon is not there, that means that doesn't have a Play Store service. So if depending on your requirement, you can select this. I will select one just for demo. I will just select this one, the first one, Pixel XL, because I already have other device I have already created. So just select this one and just click on next. And here you can see the select the Android OS, which depending on your requirement, Q, Pi, Oreo and Nugget and Lollipop and Maslow. Depending on your requirement, you can download. If there is already downloaded, then you can see that there is no download option. But if it has been downloaded, then you need to download it. So you have a download option. If you just click on this one, it will go and download the OS for you. So you can see the API label of 29, 28, 27, and basically I have downloaded from I have from 22 23 24 25 26 27 28 29, so the latest one is 29. So we'll just select the latest one, which is Android 10.0 and API level of 29, and just click on next. And from here you can just give any of your AVD name, and also you can select the default start of rotation, whether you want a portrait or a landscape. And the most important thing is the graphic, and if you have a graphic card in your PC or a laptop, you can choose a hardware, because the hardware acceleration is more faster. You can use it. If you read over here, you can see use a computer graphic card for a faster rendering. So if you have a graphic card, then the virtual device or Android virtual device will run faster. And so more setting over here, and you can also select like other thing like a CPU core and also the memory, internal storage, how much you want to give. You can also configure over here. So you can just select the internal storage like a GB, and you can just say up to 2 GB, and you can also say about the SD card, how much you want. So that's all you can configure over here. There is a lot of options that you need to configure. Then we'll just select finish for now. And that will create a new virtual device, and if you just go and run it, then the device will get started. So I'm not starting this one because I already have other device, so let me start up that one. So I have already started a virtual device over here, and let me close this one. And what I will do is over here, from here we can select the device that you want to run, which is currently running over here, which is a Pixel 2 XL API. If you want to if you go to run on multiple device, then you can see the device that is available for you. And if you see a little bit the green color over here, if you can notice here, there's a little bit green color, that means the device is online. And you can just select on a multiple device and just hit on run. So we'll just select run over here, and let us wait for the Gradle build. It may take a bit of time for a first time, because it has to configure and build out a lot of things. So let us wait for this one to complete. Yeah, so our device is booted and everything is running, and you can see our application is running. And whatever we have said over here, we have said a demo name and an age of 20. You can see that it's populated over our text box or edit text over here. And if you go and change over something like, let's go and change to 30, and I will just say as my name from here, my name, and let's change the variable name of our name to value to my name, and for the variable age we will change to 30. So let's go and rerun. So if you can see, here is a button, you can just click on this one to rerun or shift to run the app. And here also have another option, just apply a change and restart the activity. If you have I have not enabled that option to run instance run, but if you have enabled that instance run, you can just click on this one. So I haven't enabled that one, and so I will be using this one. So just click on this one, and that will start a project again, and it's quite faster for now. And you can see we have changed our variable, which is a text box value, to our edit text value to my name, and also a 30. So that's how we create a simple variable over here, which is a variable. How we learn how to create a variable previously, and we created a variable, and we created some edit text. We created a simple app that will show us our name and age when we run it, and when the device is or the app is running, then we can see our my name and a 30. That is the variable that we set, variable value that we set in our program over here. So that's it for this lesson, and we'll continue with our next lecture. Till then, have a great day.